One of the most discussed topics within the Castlevania story is the one of Sonia Belmont, and the debate of her inclusion or exclusion within the Castlevania timeline and lore. Sonia was introduced in 1997 within the game Castlevania Legends, or Demon Castle Dracula Dark Knight Prelude, the third and final Game Boy title in the series. She was also slated to be the main character in an in-development Dreamcast title, Castlevania Resurrection, which was delayed in 1999 before being outright cancelled in 2001. So, for a character that has only appeared in one officially released game, why might there be any controversy? First, we must go through who Sonia Belmont is within the game's story. Sonia is introduced as a young woman from an aristocratic family in the province of Wallachia who was born with unusual powers sometime in the Middle Ages. She hid these powers, only revealing them to her grandfather, listed in the English version as her uncle, who told her that when the time was right, not to waste her unusual gifts on herself only. This would come to a head with the rise of Count Dracula within Romania. Dracula's sudden appearance was unforeseen, and he laid waste to the countryside with his hordes of monsters and vile creatures, flexing his power. In his quest to spread his evil across Europe, Sonia's family was caught in the onslaught and decimated, all except for Sonia and her grandfather, who upon his final breath told her that it was now time to use her supernatural abilities for the good of mankind and against the evil dark threat. He instructed her to take up the family heirloom whip and use her powers for what God intended. Sonia, at the age of 17, then takes off to fight against Dracula's undead army and quell his dark uprising. In her quest, she comes across Alucard, Dracula's half-vampire son, who had grown tired of his father's evil ways and sought to banish him into the underworld for all time. After testing Sonia's strength and deeming it sufficient to help destroy Dracula, the two set off, eventually becoming romantically aligned during the journey, before Alucard eventually came to the realization that Sonia was far more suited to defeat Dracula than he was. As such, Alucard decided to submerge himself in an eternal slumber to remove his cursed bloodline from the world and ensure Dracula's death would bring an end to their bloody existence. Eventually, after fighting through Dracula's cadre of fiends, Sonia confronts the Count and ultimately defeats him, though Dracula swears to one day return. Sometime after Dracula's defeat, Sonia has a child, who, the story tells, will end up becoming the hero of legend spoken about by all. So that's Sonia's backstory. So, why is this controversial? Well, I suppose it's easiest to break things down step by step. Sonia is purported to be the first Belmont to defeat Dracula within her game. This goes against the previous prevailing point in the Castlevania lore that Trevor was the first Belmont to defeat Dracula. So, Legends attempts to retcon the previous established lore. This, of course, can be explained away as simply being a prelude to Dracula's curse, and that Sonia's story came first, but was lost to time, and Trevor largely takes the credit for being the first to beat Dracula. However, this leads to another issue. The plot point of Dracula rising to power and attacking Transylvania, along with Alucard attempting to stop him, is the same story point used in Dracula's curse. While it could be theorized that this was simply a reason Alucard was in his coffin in the first place when Trevor finds him, there's no other connection made between the events of Legends and those of Dracula's curse. It's also heavily implied within Legends that Alucard might be the father of Sonia's child, and therefore all Belmonts after her are all related to Dracula through that union, thus supposedly adding to the ties that bind the Belmonts in their war against the vampire count. It's also implied that Trevor is the child Sonia bears, as the credits state that her child will become a renowned hero of the land in the future, and in Dracula's curse it is stated that Trevor is the first Belmont in ages to fight against the darkness. So if these hints are to be believed, Alucard is Trevor's father, who then fights side by side with him in Dracula's curse. The biggest issue came after Koji Igarashi took over as the producer of the series and wanted to make his first 3D game, Lament of Innocence, and tell his story of how the feud between the Belmonts and Dracula came to be, and how Leon Belmont was actually the founder of the family, not Sonia. Iga had no hand in Legends production, and felt it contradicted his attempt to create a more stable history out of the convoluted Castlevania timeline. Thus, he declared that Legends was not a part of his established timeline, and he believes Sonia was not a good candidate to be the progenitor of the Belmont clan, possibly due to her cliched backstory that was never fleshed out with Castlevania Resurrection's release. So, where does this leave Sonia's story? Is she a footnote lost within the annals of the Castlevania timeline, or could she have a place within the legacy of the Belmont history? There is no good answer, with the story Legends tries to tell and the lore that's been heaped upon the series after the game was released contradicting each other. The easiest way to include the game would be to simply say it's an alternate universe story that isn't a part of the main franchise canon, such as it is. But could Sonia still fit into the current series timeline, though, if we throw out the romantic plot with Alucard and simply make her the first Belmont to encounter Dracula but not defeat him? Well, unfortunately, no. Even if Sonia had a child with a father who wasn't Alucard, she would take on her husband's surname. Thus, the child she had would no longer be a Belmont in name, and this means it cannot be Trevor, nor could it be any main timeline Belmont if she is meant to exist prior to Castlevania III. The next Belmont descendant who fought Dracula and wasn't a Belmont in name was Maria Renard, thus making her several generations removed from Sonia, and therefore not the child spoken of at the end of Legends. So, if Sonia was meant to be Trevor's mother, she would be alive during the early 15th century, and thus likely would not be bearing children fatherless in order to keep the Belmont surname either, especially if all her immediate family had been destroyed by Dracula and she had no support system to rear a child alone. Thus, with the evidence compiled, it is my opinion that Sonia Belmont simply does not fit within the main series timeline as it is currently, and works best as an alternate universe heroine of our own lineage. I would be curious to hear other theories, though, so feel free to look into it yourself and draw your own conclusions, or even share them in the comments. I'm always up for hearing other theories if there's a basis. Sonia's story is still an interesting one, even if it's not something that fits neatly into the patchwork timeline that is Castlevania, and she certainly is a character worth her dues. It's unfortunate that Castlevania Resurrection never released and we never got to hear any more of her tales, but as fans, we certainly can keep her legacy alive.